Okay, so I'm going to let that sink for a bit. Hello, I'm Stoyan. Please excuse my gypsy English. So I want to take also Aram for letting me do this talk. It's kind of different from my last talk I did on IT Pro Meetup. It was more technical and in-depth, and this time it's just going to be a story. I'm going to be short. So this is me. This is me.
No, that's the bottle. There you are with the.
So course. From I guess a year ago I'm a system developer, so I write software that's about backuping files, and if I do my job correctly, sometimes we can also restore those files. Before that I was a .NET developer, so that's two different worlds for me. And I was interested a little bit more about the system development space and people who write operating systems. So today I'm going to tell you the story of Terrance Davis, which is an American programmer. And I have to read this because I don't know it. And he created TempleOS, and his development was complex and unusual. It took him 10 years. And also he has lots of blogs, and he interacts very often on social media. And he refers to himself as the smartest programmer that ever lived. And maybe that is true. So I think we can hear a few words from Terry about the operating system, which is called TempleOS.
This is TempleOS. It's a 64-bit PC operating system. It has an Oracle, that's why it's called TempleOS. The main purpose is for doing offerings and of hymns and art and poems and stuff, and then getting a response from God in the Oracle.
Okay, so as you heard from the man himself, TempleOS is an operating system for making arts and crafts to present to God, and sometimes with the help of the Oracle, he responds to you. Actually, before showing you the operating system and some of the stuff it can do, I need to talk a little bit about Terry, because his story is more interesting than the operating system itself. First, before Terry started doing the OS, he was working at Ticketmaster, and he was writing operating systems for VAX mainframes. If you're old enough, you should know what is VAX architecture. Nobody here is that old. Okay, cool. And somewhere around the middle of the 1990s, Terry has started noticing that people are following him a lot. And it turns out he has schizophrenia. So one day he got a message from God, and he told him to go to Texas, and he just started driving in his car. And when he arrived in Texas, the voices on the radio told him to go to Texas. And when he arrived in Texas, he took apart his car because he was searching for listening and tracking devices on it. After that, he started to walk in the desert, and a squad car happened to pass nearby him and took him because he was in the middle of the desert. And he jumped out of the car on the highway, and he broke his collarbone. He don't play well with authority usually. And they brought him to the hospital, where he overheard the doctors talking about some x-ray they took of his collarbone, of course. Hello, Minas. How are you? That was nice timing, so I can drink. He overheard the doctors talking about x-rays, and he thought they were talking about looking for alien artifacts in his body. So he ran away and stole a truck that was idling nearby. And the cops got him again, put him in jail, actually. Lots of people call him the MacGyver of the tech industry, because then he took his glasses, broke them on the floor, took the frame and put it in an electrical outlet, hoping to break a switch and to break free from jail. But he only electrocuted himself. And when the police... hello, Joro. And when the police went to see him, he was completely bus-ass naked in his cell. And I guess that's the way the people, we want the police to find you, naked on the floor, on the jail cell. And after that, he started writing the operating system. It took him 10 years to write it. It's, he write it from scratch. It's not Unix-based.
Hmm?
Sometimes on stream. But I don't have that video. And he started writing that operating system, TempleOS, to speak to God and to get a response from him. And not only he started to write it, it was specified by God, actually. God told him what to do. I think I have a screenshot of his blog. I mean, actually everything looks like this in TempleOS. So I was about to make a line number column in editor. God nixed it. I was about to do different graphic modes when I found 800 by 600 was missing. God said just one mode, 640 by 480. I was about to write child windows. God said, God is not the author of such confusion. I asked for verification of 640 by 480, 16 colors. God said it was because of the children and their offerings. I asked about sound. God said, single voice. I asked for verification of not having different drivers. God confirmed it. So actually it doesn't support networking, the operating system, also doesn't use the graphics card.
So it's super secure.
Actually, yeah, it's one of the most... yeah, and he wrote everything from scratch, even wrote the bootloader himself. Doesn't use GURP, something like that. He wrote the compiler, he has his own language, it's called Holy C. It's a 64-bit operating system, it runs on everything. It has an oracle that gives you the response from God. He made the compiler, he made the graphics library, he made drivers, and usually he says, I made fucking everything. He made also, he made his own, I forgot the word. No, seriously, I forgot. Never mind. So, but he's quite
The CIA niggers glow in the dark. You can see them if you're driving. You just run them over. That's what you do. Fucking CIA niggers.
So one of the things he hates the most is the CIA niggers, which are taunting him every day, and they usually glow in the dark, and you can see them when you're driving, you can hit them with your car. So actually that's a very short clip that shows every interaction with Terry ever in every social media, and that's how he behaves all the time. So he doesn't like the CIA, he doesn't like niggers, obviously, and I wanted to imagine, to think about actually the some of the pioneers like Steve Jobs and Wozniak, Torvalds, Bill Gates. Actually, if they got such serious disease as Terry when they were still developing their big products, which were the first hit of their companies, would people make the difference between the accomplishment and the person itself? Because in Terry's case, that's just the thing. I mean, he was a brilliant programmer that got big troubles with schizophrenia, and actually the thing he made is not useful at all, and it has some great feature. I'm gonna tell you about them, and it's kind of a sad story. So, and the other thing Terry doesn't like actually is incompetent people. So this is gonna be our last clip, and after I'm gonna show some demonstration of installing TempleOS, writing a little bit of Horacy, some assembly, some other cool shit. I forgot very special slide. So this is the story of Terry, told by Terry in his blog. It's now took down from the internet. I'm not going to read the whole thing. It's too explicit for me to say out loud. I'm being recorded, but I live in a CIA prison. A nigger runs my prison. In prison, the nigger tries to torment me. We can take away his knives by confessing every day. In about 2000, I masturbated fantasizing about my niece, Lenny. She looks like Star Trek 7 of 9. In 1985, at my sister's wedding, I stuck my crotch on the hot tub drain because it kinda sucked. In 1985, I tried to get a dog to lick my dick. And so forth and so on. Actually, it gets more explicit the younger he was. I mean, I think it says that he sucked his brother's dick somewhere. So, and the last clip is about incompetent people, because that's what Terry hates the most after the CIA and the niggers.
Okay, listen, little faggot. Have you ever written a compiler? Have you ever written an interrupt routine, you little faggot? Have you ever written an interrupt routine, you little faggot? No, you haven't, because you're a faggot, okay? Why don't you go write an interrupt routine, faggot? Pascal, you're fucking in the ocean with some nigger in the deep ocean. You got no clue what's underneath you, you little faggot. Do you know how many people can boot it? It's because you're trying to use box, you retard nigger. You're trying to load the kernel by yourself. Do it like a white man. A white man uses an ISO file. This is the way a white operating system is installed. So if you're laughing because I got 2 gig from my code, you're a nigger. TempleOS is single address map. It doesn't use paging. For an average MIT nigger, they cannot understand. They have their minds crunched into a narrow blinder by the CIA.
By the CIA, goddamn Central Intelligence Agency. So it's time to see TempleOS itself. I mean, I have it installed a couple of times actually. So we're gonna call it Temple 2, and it's type other, and it's 64-bit, and we need 2 gigs for our code, as you heard before that, because it needs at least 2 gigabytes of memory, and it doesn't use paging. For an average MIT nigger, that should be not clear enough. The other thing actually doesn't matter. The ISO file actually is 16 megabytes, very small, and it has a light version. If you think 16 is too much, it has 2 megabytes distro, and it needs 2 gigabytes of code. So let's see. No, we're gonna scale it. Nope. Yes. So we need to install it. You press a button. It asks us if you are going to install it on a virtual machine, and we are. And that's good, because if you install it on a real hardware, it asks for a hard drive ID, because it doesn't have automatic scan for that. Just Terry things. He made everything, but maybe when it's installing, I can tell you a couple of interesting stuff that I found about TempleOS. I have spent whole 5 hours with it, so the compiler, actually the command line feeds directly into the compiler, so everything you write in the command line goes to the compiler, and it's a C compiler, but kind of different. It's a just-in-time compiler, and you get edit everything you want on the go, gonna compile and run usually. It's prone to crashing when you write something stupid. That's why Terry doesn't like stupid people. Actually, the files with the source files is with extension HC, which is Holy C, and after that is .z, and that's something interesting. If you make a file .z, it's gonna be compressed, and every time you open, it's gonna uncompress automatically. I'm gonna compress after that. That's a feature of the operating system. Reboot now. No. We are gonna close it. because we want to unmount the ISO file like a Whiteman, and that's how a Whiteman operating system works. That's his bootloader, and he made everything from scratch, as I said a couple of times, and he's gonna tell you if you watch him like thousands of times. So we're gonna write some Holy C, we're gonna compile it, gonna run it, we're gonna uncompile it. We're not gonna take the tour. Actually, it has lots of documentation. This thing over here is autocomplete. It's a pure trash actually. I'm gonna close that one. The cursor is great. Doesn't support child Windows. So first maybe it's good to show the Oracle because that's what gives you the response from God. When you press F7, every time you get a random word from a random string generator, and that is the word of God. Actually. So maybe we're gonna try the writing something, some function in the command line to see if it goes to the compiler, gonna call it after that. Something really simple. Every demo is really simple. So U0, which is void by the way, and it's special void that Terry made that has no overhead. We're gonna say count bracket i64, that is an integer I, because we're gonna write a for loop and you cannot initialize variables in it. Because don't know why. So from 0 it's gonna be like 2, 3. I'm gonna count a little bit. So where is my percent? Yeah, it's usually 5, but it's not moving. Oh, it didn't crash, okay.
If you want, I can give you a different keyboard. I think you're a nigger, man.
Yeah. It's not working. Okay, so I know what to do. Great, I have done it thousands of times at home. Worked every single time. At least it's fast. Nope. Fuck that shit. Okay, it works. I mean, the command line, it feeds into the compiler, and when you call the function, it's gonna count to 4. That's what I don't want to do. You call a function in the command line, you roll the program in the command line, it's just in time. It works. It's cool. Maybe not that useful. So we're gonna fire up an editor. We're gonna call it, no, test. It's gonna be hello. Hello dot holy C. I'm gonna be compressed.
It was supposed to crash when you type hello. It was supposed to crash when you type hello thing.
Yeah, it sometimes do. So does the editor. And actually it doesn't have his variation of C doesn't have main function. Every call that's outside of a function runs line after line. So but we're gonna make a function because we're cool. It's gonna be main, and it's gonna write a hello world. And actually, if we do a just a plain string, it's gonna put it through printf. And we don't even need that. Every plain string is gonna get printed on the screen because that's a big feature of TempleOS. And let's see if it works. It works, hello world. So another nice feature is that we can write assembly, but we don't need a block for the assembly. So move arrayx hello. We're gonna call a macro that terimate.
That was a message from God that your time is up.
Yeah. Okay. Unfortunate. It froze. I'm gonna go to the final demo, which is the best. No, for sure. We're gonna finish that one. Maybe, maybe not. Okay, we're not gonna finish it because we're gonna open that file, the same file, not wasting time. And I'm gonna make some space on the top. Gonna show you how we can insert sprites. Should be control R. We're gonna make a sprite. Okay, enter doesn't work sometimes. And it's gonna be a shiftable 3D mesh, actually. And I think that's the greatest feature of the operating system. Never read that, don't care. So capital P. Thickness 25. We're gonna make something. See, it spins. It's cool. I tell you. I have to exit from here because otherwise it's gonna crash. So where is my key, man?
Hey, it doesn't use GPU for that.
No, actually everything's renders on the CPU because that's Terrace world. And sprite, some dark magic here. Everything, some hotkey that's not mentioned in the documentation. You have to watch the streams of Terrain. And we need a pointer to the sprite. And I think we press escape, not enter, which is totally fine to place it there. It doesn't work.
What's supposed to happen?
Your for loop is from 5 to 5.
For 5 to 5? Shouldn't work. I think the compiler was smarter, man. Yeah, but there one over the top of the other, that the sprite, that's a 3D mesh. And you get it right from the editor. And the last, very last thing I'm gonna show you, because I know you're bored already. Uncompile function. Main. You can uncompile from the compiler. Make sense? That's the red thing in assembly. We uncompiled it. It has some other nice features, TempleOS. If we press Ctrl N, we can see that Terry made a menu for us. It has fun games and it has unfun games. So maybe we're gonna place little Varum, and that's actually offering to God, so don't laugh. Си, врум. My CPU is it's almost dead, and I have 24 FPS. It's kind of slow, actually. And some unfun game. Castle of Frankenstein. Oh, that's unfun, man. Ah. See? Someone with epilepsy? We can... And very nice. So you can download TempleOS from TempleOS.org. It's in the public domain, so you can do everything you want with it, actually. It's not even open source, it's in the public domain. It doesn't have a GitHub repo because Terry doesn't believe in GitHub. Believes only in God, in getting a response from him. And I think the final word for the OS should be from the Oracle. That doesn't work. Oh, it works. And the sad story is that actually last year Terry died. He was smashed by a train. It's not funny. His family took down almost everything he made from the website. Most of the things you saw there, not there. And the only thing that's left on TempleOS.org is the operating system itself and a link to donations for people with schizophrenia. And that is a very short version of the story of Terry Davis. A great programmer that encountered mental illness, and from there everything went downhill. Thank you.